The best way to connect your laptop or PC to multiple monitors is to check first and install later, avoiding therefore to waste time and money. Please do not skip this video and pay attention to everything until the very end. My name is Nicola Scanni. With a degree in multimedia and a passion for technology, I have a tendency to pass along my knowledge in a very simple way. In this step-by-step tutorial for Windows users, I will tell you how to check your graphic card and what to do for negative results. Next, I will consider a positive result, and I will go ahead and actually tell you how to install two extra monitors on your laptop and/or your PC. In addition, I will explain the differences between a portrait and a landscape setup, and between inline monitors versus splitter setup. Do not worry, if it sounds complicated, I can assure you, it is not. I will explain it in a very simple way, therefore, even if you feel you are a beginner, or if you have very little knowledge, it will be easy, just like a walk in a park. Ready? Let's go! First, before we go to buy many monitors, we need to check the graphics card. We go to Start, with the Windows logo, we right-click on Computer, and we click on Properties. In the newly opened window, we click on Device Manager. And in the next window, we click on the arrow of Display Adapters that will reveal the name of the graphic card. Here, we right-click on the card, choosing Properties. And when we choose the Details tab, with the right click, we can actually copy the card's name. We can then open our browser and paste it in the search bar, adding right after how many monitors we have in mind to set up. Read and look for answers. I found a negative result, but I already have two extra monitors, an old Philips V190 and an LG TV, and I want to go ahead and connect them. First, I connect the Philips monitor via VGA cable. And then, I use an HDMI to connect my TV. You may notice some difference in terms of quality. The VGA analog connection displays a noticeably fuzzier picture with less vivid colors. Now, I want to simply make sure, is it true that I cannot have this kind of setup? In order to check, I can click on the taskbar, right-click on the graphic card, choosing Open Control Panel. On the new window, I click on Setup Multiple Displays. Here, when I checkmark my Philips monitor, a message pops up that says this GPU supports up to two displays. Every NVIDIA GeForce graphics card from 600 and up supports multiple displays. However, my model is a 670M and it is just an update of the original 570M and therefore it is not sufficient. I may need to purchase an additional graphics card, but before I buy it, I need to make sure I have enough space if I own a microcomputer tower, basically if I have an open PCIe slot, as well as a power supply unit that can handle the extra strain. Then I will buy one with the same product family, connecting them using SLI NVIDIA or Crossfire AMD. Although you may technically run NVIDIA and AMD cards side by side, I really don't recommend it. If you have instead a positive result, let's go ahead and right-click with your mouse on a free space of your computer screen and choose Screen Resolution. In the new window, make sure you choose to extend your monitors. This setting will allow you to play and listen to your favorite video by dragging it from the computer to the TV or monitor and have them display two different videos at the same time. The computer screen is also free to make your Google search or to use any other software for your convenience. If you're planning on doing a lot of gaming or watching videos that span multiple monitors, you should use a DVI splitter that uses more cable ends. In addition, it is better to have the same type of monitors in order to display the game with the picture distributed uniformly. If you are a blogger or a journalist, it's a totally different story. You want to switch from the horizontal view to a portrait in order to simplify or even avoid any scrolling. Just make sure to select the monitor before to switch your display from landscape to portrait. Here you may see a setup example of vertical settings. Nice, right? Well, that's it. If you like my tutorial, do not forget to subscribe to my channel. Remember that every first weekend of the month, I upload a new tutorial online here on YouTube. If you have any question, please leave a message. I will answer them as soon as possible. Thank you for listening and enjoy your multiple monitors. Ciao!